Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today we're gonna be talking about the law of attraction. Now it's 2019. I feel like the majority of you guys have heard about the law of attraction up until this point. And if not, you are obviously living under a rock. I'm just kidding. We all come across things at our own time, but it's really important that I revisit the law of attraction now because I feel like in a lot of ways, we have been neglecting it. It's something that was once trending and then we walked away from it and we're not even thinking about it anymore. If you look at any type of manifestation and putting something out there and receiving it, it all comes back to these core kind of principles and rules that help things to come into your life. And I want to talk about them. I want to break them down regardless of your belief system, regardless of your spirituality, regardless of your religion. So first things first is, what is the law of attraction? So pretty much the law of attraction is what you want essentially wants you to. In order for you to receive the things that it is that you want, you have to kind of be that thing or match the energy of it. That's why it's called the law of attraction, because like and like, these two separate things, they're separate but they're the same, and they find each other and they magnetize towards each other. This could literally be anything. It could be a job, a relationship, a car, an ice cream cone, a $20 bill. And I have many stories where I have manifested a person, a place, a thing, an event, a circumstance, my book, this place, this apartment, literally all that it is that you see is something that it is that I manifested in some way, shape, or form. The first thing that you want to do with the law of attraction seems very simple, but I honestly feel like it's one of the most complex, is to actually know what it is that you want. Now, as crazy as that sounds, I honestly feel like a lot of people, they have this theory, they have this idea or a concept of something that they think they want, but if they sat with it in meditation or sat with it within themselves, they would find a little bit of discord. They would find a little bit of imbalance, which I thought I wanted this thing, but if I was to receive it, would it really make me happy? So if I put it out there, if I call it out into the universe, am I gonna receive it? Most likely, chances are no. Or if you do receive it, it's almost like an instant rejection of your spirit. It truly doesn't last. The reason why is because, in my belief, every single one of us has desires put in our heart, placed in our heart by God, by the divine, that at some point in our lives, once we go through a certain series of circumstances, we are triggered to ask for that thing. It's every single one of those lessons that teaches you, okay, I'm learning more and more about myself. The more that you learn about yourself, the more that you understand yourself and you understand your wants, your needs, your desires, and also your weaknesses and your potential pitfalls. A really good example for this are relationships. The relationships that I called into my life at the start of my journey are going to be so different than the relationships that I will call into my life now. This is because I have evolved as a human being and as a woman, and my relationships at the start of my journey mirrored that I was at the start of my journey. And now that I'm here in this present, what it is that I want for myself is totally different. Now, if I was to ask for what I want now, back then, would I be able to receive it? And if I was to receive it, would I be able to keep it? The chances are definitely like no. That's why for me personally, you guys have heard me talk about this multiple times in interviews and on my blog, on my Instagram, and on my YouTube, that the relationships that I called out, that I put out, I knew that ultimately I wanted, you know, this grand image, but who I was at the start of my journey would not be able to maintain and to care for and tend to and even be a good partner to the person that it was that I ultimately was going to call into my life. So for that reason, I sat within myself, within my meditation, and I sat with the divine and we had a conversation. Was I ready to have that relationship? And although it was something that my heart desired, I knew within that moment that I was not prepared, and that instead of asking for that thing automatically, I needed to ask for the lesson or the relationship that was going to help me to prepare it. Now, the reason why I'm giving you guys this example is because I knew what it was that I wanted, but I also knew instinctively deep within that there were certain obstacles and battlefields that I had to go through and to grow through in order to receive this ultimate manifestation of this dream relationship or this dream thing that it was that I wanted to have and accept within my life. And the same thing is true for you. Again, I knew ultimately what it was that I wanted, but I knew that in order for me to get that, what I needed to ask for is this series of events or this relationship or this thing that was going to teach me so that I could almost essentially level up through that experience. So on a personal level, for those of you guys that are confused and scratching your head, on a personal level, when I started dating, I was not comfortable with telling someone that I liked them. Like emotional intimacy, I was really having a hard time being vulnerable in that way. It's so important to have emotional vulnerability and emotional intimacy within a relationship. How could you have an intimate relationship with someone and not be able to connect with them on that level? So knowing that about myself and knowing that that was a struggle for myself, that was the first thing that I called into my life, and within under a week, it manifested. My first major relationship was the first thing to teach me that level of emotional intimacy. And after that relationship had ended, and after that relationship served its time, and it was the signal, I received the signal for me to let this relationship go, I knew that I wanted to have this, again, ultimate dream relationship, this dream manifestation. So I wanted to sit back with myself within my meditation and have a heart-to-heart with God again, a heart-to-heart with the divine and within myself, and say, okay, what was it that I learned from that relationship? And what do I need to know in order to receive, again, this ultimate manifestation of this dream thing? So the next obstacle presented itself. I saw it for what it was, and that was what I called in. That is what I manifested in order to teach me so that I could learn that lesson again, because my heart desired something bigger. But in order for me to get there, I had to know my strengths and my weaknesses and know exactly what it is that I needed to ask for. So I know that that sounds really confusing and complex, and it does require a healthy dose of vulnerability with yourself and respect for yourself and your own journey. But when it comes to the laws of attraction, if you have this desire within your heart that seems out of grasp and seems out of reach, and you know that you're not prepared for it, that thing is still, it's still out there for you. But you need to match the vibration of this higher thing, this higher level thing that you yourself may actually have to level up to. So knowing what it is that you want is really kind of difficult, because when you see it and you feel it and experience that within your dream state, within your intuitive state, you are then really vulnerable. Why are you vulnerable? Because knowing what it is that you truly want for yourself makes you almost self-examine your own flaws and make necessary changes in order to help you to reach that destination. That's why this is actually a really complex step. And I feel like the internet's not really talking about it. We all think that we know what we want, and we do, but a part of knowing what it is that we want is knowing where we are currently and then changing ourselves to match the vibration of things that we truly desire. Another example of this is someone who knows what they want for their career, but at this point in their life, they don't have the dedication or the commitment in order to make that career a reality. So the first thing that they need to do is to see what it is that they want, but to match the vibration of that and to make changes within themselves. So they need to see what it is that they ultimately want for themselves, this higher vision, this higher ultimate desire, and know that in order to get to that, what you want now is to learn how to be more committed, to learn how to do whatever it takes in order to make your business grow, to learn how to follow through with the things that you promise your clients or the things that you promise yourself or your employees. So it's almost like a stepping stone to get you to this larger picture. And that's okay. A lot of people have issues with this because they don't like the fact that life is a journey. Like, for real, they don't like the fact that life is a journey and that it's constantly unfolding and there's gonna be lessons left and right. You guys know me, I'm an astrologer. I'll pull your chart and I can tell you right now what these obstacles are gonna look like and what obstacles you're facing currently. Instead of hiding from that and pretending like it doesn't exist, I will show you how to face them and to work with them so that you can grow in a way that feels good and not makes you a victim of it. So much of us feel like a victim, but that's a topic for another discussion. So the first thing with the law of attraction is to ultimately know exactly what it is that you want. And when you see what it is that you want, it's like looking in a mirror. Because if this is given to you by the divine and given to you by God for you to have this desire placed in your heart, then you are that thing. In a lot of ways, you're the mirror of it. And if you're not right now the mirror of it, then so much of you is going to change so that you match the image of what it is that you see for yourself. That goes right back to knowing exactly what it is that you want. Because if you are calling out into the universe for this thing, then you need to make sure that this thing is worthy of you changing your energy for, in a way that is positive. Now, I don't want you guys to misconstrue what I'm saying and say and think that I'm saying that you need to change. No, what I'm saying is that we all need to evolve. We are all always evolving. For many of you guys, you are ready now for this thing, for this career, for this relationship, for this travel. And if that's the case, you already match that vibration. You know what it is that you want. So if that's the case, then we're gonna move on to the next step. The next step is to feel what it is that you're feeling and just sit with it and vibe with it. Feeling is so important when it comes to setting intentions and the law of attraction, because feelings are very, very powerful. A lot of our feelings come from how our brain is perceiving things, our perception of our world and our relationship with the world. And our brains and our thoughts and the words that we speak are the conscious manifestors. Like, they're the conscious tools that we use to manifest. We see this all throughout astrology. We see this all throughout the cycles of life, and we see this all throughout tarot. But again, that's a topic for another discussion. But for those of you guys that enjoy astrology, look at the influence and the power of Mercury and how we use that, the mind. Mercury rules the mind in our communication. So look at how Mercury, the power of Mercury when it comes to calling in and manifesting things and the thoughts that is that you think and that vibration, your perception, and how you interpret information and you interpret yourself within this world. There's a lot of power, but that, again, that's a topic for another discussion. So what we want to do is we want to connect with our feelings once we have the thought and we know what it is that we want. Whatever it is that you want should make you feel powerful. It should make you feel ambitious. It should make you feel like this is something that makes you feel good and that you don't need to strive for it, but it's something that you want to receive into your life and you know it's gonna be so good. It's going to make you feel good. Also, your feelings are a large signal to how your energy is vibing with a person, a place, and a thing. So we know this within our instincts. Our instincts will tell us, okay, something is not right in this environment. It's my feeling, my gut instinct, and the way that my body physically feels and mentally feels that something is not right. For that reason, I need to get the heck out of here. So it's our feelings that absorb the energy of the environment and let us know that this is not where we belong. The same thing is true with the things that are directing us to where we belong and the things that are helping us to call in the things that we actually desire. Your feelings will tell you that this is a resounding yes for me because it makes me feel strong. If you sit with that feeling when you visualize the thing that it is that you want, which is step three, then that thing is definitely going to manifest within your life. However, if you see that thought, or if you are calling in this one thing and it makes you feel sad or depressed or anxious, then that is what you're going to call back into your life because that's the energy that you're putting out there. And also, the thing that you're calling out is matching the energy within you that brings you anxiety. So that is what you will receive because that is where you're at currently within that place. Why would you call in something that makes you anxious? Why would you call in something that makes you feel powerless? So take a step back and go back into what it is that you want. Because what it is that you want, if it's making you anxious, and if it's making you feel bad, is it truly something that is that you want within your life? And I really want to say that statement and caution those who are calling in specific people. For example, let's say you have an ex that has made you feel bad in the past and you really want that person to come back into your life. Well, they have their own energy, but when you sit with that thought and you see that person's face and you have that person's energy in your mind's eye and intuitively you're connecting with them and it makes you feel bad, that's an energy that is beneath you and below you, and that's what you're gonna call back into your life again. You have to ask yourself, is it truly your ex that it is that you want, or do you want a relationship where it's mutual love and respect and communication and support and intimacy? And that goes right back to know what you want. So many of us are quick to call out for these things, not realizing that's truly not what it is that we desire. And if we connect with our feelings, we would know that in an instant that this is not where I belong, this is not where I need to be. The next step is visualization. Now, this is one of my favorite parts of the process because this is where you really intimately connect with it. And it's more than just a feeling now. Now you're kind of seeing it. Now you're kind of observing it in your mind's eye. Something that really helps along with this visualization process is something that people were doing when they were studying The Secret, which was the book, or watching the movie The Secret, which they were creating vision boards. The reason why the vision board works so successfully is because it's taking the thought and turning it into a physical so that you can see it in the present now. Are vision boards tools that can help you to reach success when it comes to manifestation? Absolutely, for the reasons that I just mentioned, but it's not for everybody. Some of us like to stay within our third eye and leave it there and visualize it or work magic or work our intention. And for those of you guys who are like, okay, well, Jess, can you talk about that? I actually have a video about how to set intention, powerful intentions, on my YouTube channel, so I will link it down below. So if you feel called to do the vision board, by all means do it. I actually have a vision board of sorts on my wall right now, and it's technically inspired by the tarot cards, and I talked about that in another video, which I will link down below in the description box. Another step that I think is really successful that helps, and I use this all the time, I'm not gonna work with manifesting and setting intention or doing visualization without actually doing this stuff, and it is to write things down. Writing it down for me is so important. As a Virgo, we're ruled by Mercury. Mercury rules written communication and things that we think and the things that we speak. But it takes the thought and makes it into a physical form, and as I'm writing it down in full detail of what it is that I see for myself and how I want to feel and what I want to receive within my life, it's almost like a petition, it's almost like a letter to God or the divine or my higher self that I am using to call in. So it takes that concept of a thought and it turns it into a physical representation, but words are just my thing. But definitely follow your vibes with that. Hey, it's me again. Sorry, my camera's space got all filled up and I was like, I am not going to leave this video and leave my people just hanging on a thread. We are going to move forward, so I'm filming from my camera. But the next stage that I want to talk to you guys about and the next step is to totally detach. Now, I know that people say this is the hardest part. For me, it's not, but I understand why people say it, because if you know something that you want is something that you really truly want, it's a desire of your heart and you've visualized it and you have that feeling, why would you call in the feeling? Why would you call in all of these emotions and then just walk away from it? But the thing is that what you call it what you will, but I like to always give the recognition and the credit to a higher power and also to the higher power within myself, because I feel like God is within us, God is within me, God is within you. But that's just my personal beliefs. But the reason why you want to detach is because you give it space. You give divine, you give energy, the universe, the space to kind of work and manipulate things in order to match the vibration of what it is that you want. And the reason why that's important is because our brains, as a human being, our brains are so limited in how we can conceptualize things and as far as how we can visualize things and how it would all make sense to us, when the divine, our spirit, our higher self, is connected to the infinite possibilities. The reality is that as a physical human being, we are very creative, we are very imaginative, and we can think of a million things that something can happen, but we don't know how it's going to happen within our lives. And even with all the thoughts that we can think and all the creative ways that we can spin how this is going to manifest within our lives, the only person and the only thing that truly knows how things are going to work out is essentially the universe, the divine, and your higher self. So if that's the case, what happens is that when our brains are trying to move things forward, we end up blocking and locking our energy in with trying to make things work and trying to plan our next steps. When in reality, the best thing that you want to do is to stay open and allow the universe to kind of guide you by just doing what it is that you would normally be doing. For example, this morning I was saying to myself, you know, it's my day off. What are some things that I would like to do for this day? You know, I want to go on a date, which I did do. I want to get really good coffee, which I did receive, and I want to go for a bike ride. And I wanted to relax, and I wanted Franklin to stop growling while I'm filming. Oh, Franklin! Come here. What are you growling at? That last part I'm just kidding about, but for real, all of the things that I mentioned before are things that it was that I wanted. And let me tell you, like, I went on the date, it was great, I had my coffee, it was awesome, and one of my friends just texted me while my camera was, you know, pooped out and died, and was like, yo, do you want to go for a bike ride? And I'm like, huh, yes I do, check. So it's just like me living my life. I know that's such a small tiny example, but I use the laws of attraction, I use manifestation and setting intention every day of my life in order to create the day that I want. Now, it may not be necessarily within that day, but it could be within a week, it could be within a month, and it could be within a year. At the same time, as I'm putting things out into the universe and as I'm calling it out and I know what it is that I want, I listen for the response back. There are multiple times when I thought that I wanted something and the universe intercepted it, or God intercepted it, the divine intercepted it and said, Jess, what you want is not big enough. And I'm sitting there like, this is the biggest thing I could ever imagine for myself. How are you going to tell me this is, you know, not big enough? This is the biggest thing that I could possibly think of. Like, how could it get better? And God said the same thing. The divine said the same thing. And I listened to that. My intuition spoke to me. And within a year, within 2 years, actually it was 2 years, the biggest hopes and dreams and desires that I had for my heart were surpassed
3 times, and I received amazing, amazing blessing within my life, amazing gifts from God, from the universe, because within that moment, I knew what I wanted, but I was also listening and I was detaching from my own outcome, and I received bigger, better than what it was that I could have ever imagined. And the same is true for you. Now, I know some people will take that message and it will resonate different, like it'll hit a chord differently, depending on your personal belief systems. But I have a really strong connection and relationship to the divine, because I've always, in the beginning of my journey, I really questioned it and I really pushed back. I really pushed out. And because of that, I'm concrete and I'm solid within my own spiritual beliefs and my own relationship with the divine and my relationship within myself. So detaching is really a space for you to give God and the divine the space to do what they're going to do, and allow the universe and energies to work their magic on your behalf for things that they already told you through your feeling, through your heart, that they were going to give you, and that was a part of your destiny. Now, for those of you guys that are connected to astrology, which you know I am too, the desires of your heart could be mapped within your astrology chart, within your natal chart. So those are some signs and some signals, almost as a compass, to act as confirmation for the things that it is that you've been feeling. So that's another thing too. Now, the last thing I want to say before I go on this bike ride, because y'all know that I manifested it, I called it out this morning and it just manifested within a second of my phone dying, within that time frame, is what happens when you receive blockages. Now, I get this question a lot. If you're experiencing a lot of blockages, 9 times out of 10, it's because you are trying too hard, you are anxious, you are forcing it, or what you have called out for yourself and what is that you want for yourself doesn't match actually what is that you truly, truly want for yourself. And that's when you have to go back to step one, which is, okay, is this truly something that is that I want? Am I calling out for something that truly isn't for me? And if you sit with your feeling and if you know yourself, you will know that answer. That is not something that someone else can tell you. It is something that you have to learn how to connect within yourself, or else you're going to be in these repeating patterns, these repeating cycles of disappointment, frustration, delay, and things collapsing around you instead of building up around you as you are building towards it. Okay, so I know that is a lot. I know that I sped through this, but again, I'm a Virgo and we have a lot of information that we want to share. We can get pretty wordy, and I also had coffee and I'm in good spirits right now because of my date earlier, and shout out to the person if they're watching. But yeah, I mean, it's a lot to take in, but those are the truths. And if you guys have any questions about the law of attraction and setting intentions and manifesting, feel free to leave them down in the comments. I am more than happy to share my own personal experiences with working with the law of attraction, the things that I've manifested within my life, from the book that I wrote to the apartment that I'm in to just everything, you guys. I'm telling you everything. So, and interestingly enough, I'm in a space currently where I'm not manifesting because I'm in this like void space, this quiet space, which I call like an energetic limbo, a spiritual solitude space, and that's because my spirit is allowing me to rest and I'm called to rest before I call out for the next thing. So some of you guys are in that too, and if you would like me to talk about that void space, I'm more than happy to do that. I did talk about it in detail with my Sacred Circle Tarot School students. And we talked about the number 9 and the symbolism of that, and it was just such a powerful conversation, and I'm more than willing to share that with you guys, or maybe to do a reading. So if you would like to see that, and if that's something that you're interested in, let me know down in the comments. But that being said, I'm gonna put on some chapstick, I'm gonna grab some water, I'm gonna grab my book bag, I'm gonna hop on my bike, and I'm gonna go meet up with my friends. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.